Executive Director of the Bowling Green International Festival, Kim Mason. Thanks for joining us today, Kim.
Thank you for having me.
First of all, I want to talk about a little bit about the history of the Bowling Green International Festival.
Okay, well, the festival actually started in 1989 as a Japanese festival, and then later it became the ethnic festival, and now it's the international festival.
Okay. What is the objective of the international festival?
Basically, to bring all the people in our community from various cultural heritage together to celebrate and share the diverse, you know, experiences of where they're from.
Now, I know there are different countries that are involved in the Bowling Green International Festival. Can you tell us a little bit about those different countries?
Well, certainly Japan is always a major focus of the festivals. We have the Japanese dancers come out and teach all the festival goers some dancing and join in and fill the streets with a costumed dance. This year we're actually highlighting Bosnian and Hispanic culture, and one of our featured performers is Melina Almandover, and she's salsa merengue and Latin pop, and she will be doing both a nighttime performance and a daytime performance. We have a Bosnian band, which is actually a local group called Third Generation. They do traditional Bosnian dance, and all sorts of other Cambodian, Vietnamese, Celtic entertainment. There's over 15 countries represented in just the entertainment alone. And then in addition, we have cultural display booths where the children get little passports and they can go to each gateway country booth and learn about the culture of that country and have their name written in the language from the country and get their passport stamped. That's always kind of a highlight for the kids.
Now, speaking of entertainment, I know this year that you all have six stages of entertainment, and I know each year that we have the Bowling Green International Festival, the entertainment is always a big event. Can you tell us about that?
Well, the street dance, which is actually following the festival and always a main thing, is going to be a huge 60-foot stage with a neat light show and all kinds of things, and it will feature Pat Haney, who it's going to be his CD release party, and so we're real excited about that. He's kind of Americana roots music, and then Melina Salsa and also Michael Goff Delta Style Blues will be at the street dance. In addition to that, during the day we have a concert stage which will feature bands, Spanish dance groups and various bands, and that stage actually also includes Dwight Murdy is with his bluegrass band will be bringing Josh Graves, who is really legendary in the bluegrass scene. We're really excited to be having them. Then we have an exhibition stage which is going to have 10 different dance groups throughout the day, Cambodian dancers and Spanish dancers, I mentioned the Japanese dancers, various things like that. A children's stage is new this year, and that features storytellers, some performing arts groups, and all sorts of things that appeal to the kids. The Small World Singers come every year, and that's a chorus made up of children from the community, from ethnic neighborhoods. A lot of Bosnian and Hispanic children are involved in that group. One new thing we're excited about is the International Open Mic Tent. Now that is going to be a stage where we're encouraging talented people from the community to share their cultural heritage with us and their music. And actually, you know, they could be comedians or the storytellers or just any sort of performance. And if they come and sign up at 10 a.m., then we'll just do sort of first come, first serve and get as many on there and give them a stage that we can.
Now, along with all the great entertainment, of course, is the fantastic food that the International Festival has. Can you tell us about some of the different kinds of food that they'll have at this year's festival?
Mm-hmm. We're going to have several different kinds of Mexican and Hispanic type food. Some authentic Indian cuisine will be there. Food from Australia. The food is definitely something that's a major thing, and there's all sorts of both professional food vendors and then groups like the Asian American Club and the Bosnian Club that put together a table and let you sample some of their favorite treats. So,
okay, and aside from the food and all the entertainment, one great thing about the International Fresh Festival is that it's free.
Yeah, it's free, and a lot of the activities for children are free as well, too. We're really trying to feature children's activities rather than recreational-based, being sort of educational and artistic. A local artist, Andy Rudloff, is drawing a mural for us on panels, and the kids will have little square tiles that they can decorate, and then she's recruiting some other local artists to place them and create a mosaic, which we'll then be able to display in the future. We have Heather's Performing Arts Studio. She's written an original song for the festival, and we'll be choreographing it, and kids can join in her workshop and learn the dance and then get up on stage several times through the day and perform it. And Kentucky Arts Council works very closely with an artist named Willie Roscoe that's coming, and we're real excited about Willie. He does African-American inspired art, and it's all made from Kentucky driftwood and using bone, and he even makes stains crushing berries and things like that, and it's really neat stuff. And he's going to be bringing all of his materials he uses and working with the kids all day long, teaching them how to find art in their piece of driftwood and then let them carve on it and stain it and bring it home.
And once again, can you tell us when and where will the festival be?
Okay, it's October 6th on Fountain Square in Bowling Green, and it begins at 10 a.m. and the street dance will end at 10 p.m. Most of the vendors will be staying till about 6. And we are still looking for more vendors and demonstrators, too. If anybody's interested, they can call 781-5338, or they can check out our website, www.bginternationalfest.com, and that has all kinds of information about everything on it.
Okay, well, it sounds great. We really appreciate you for joining us today. Thanks a lot, Kim.
Well, thank you for having me.
Up next, we'll tell you how you can network with the professional women in Bowling Green. Stay with us.